I feel like art can show Black history in a different perspective than most people, especially white people, aren't able to see. And it's also great at storytelling and retelling those stories of unsung heroes or Black history activists and things of that nature. Art that touches on historical elements, whether it's symbols and people in general, I feel is very important. I like kind of focusing on, the regular people, or, people that we don't know of, and make them look beautiful. So I wanted to do the murals to kind of, take it up another level. Then, if we're doing them in the public spaces, it forces everybody to actually see the artwork. And it starts the conversation. People ask, who is this person? What did they do? Why are they on this wall? You're in a city that's 90% Black, and we need murals that represent the people that live in our community. And those are Black people. There should be a conversation on why African-American art in white spaces are always disfigured. Notice that. So that's why when I paint Black people, I like to paint them in their own natural form. My goal is to simply just paint as many Black people in this city of Jackson as I can. You know what I'm saying? And these Black people are going to be beautiful. These Black people are going to be uplifting. They're going to have positive messages and positive outcomes. But I believe that Black people in every neighborhood, whether it's Shady Oaks, Presidential Hills, North, South Jackson, she had the same right to view art in public spaces as everybody else, especially the artists and funders. People shouldn't have to go, to other cities or across town to experience great public art. So I try to provide that to people in environments, neighborhoods, and, the neighborhoods we grew up in.